Todd Golden. Todd, you guys had the lead about midway through the second half, up 10. The Cougars kept coming at you, and even in the late going up 4, but BYU really stiffened up defensively the last couple 3 minutes. Your thoughts on this ball game?
Honestly, I thought we played well. We just didn't make a shot. We were the better team. We were up 10 in the second half, had multiple opportunities to close them out, and didn't make shots. 3 for 23 from three. Got to competing against a club like this that's good, used to winning, you can't go 3 for 23 from three and expect to win the ball game. We shot the ball well from the foul line. That was a positive, but man, we had multiple opportunities to just shut the door on them, and we just gave them life. And that's what happens against good teams. You give them life, they're going to come back to win the game.
Talk about the front line, really on both sides. I thought it was a big battle between your guys, Misalski and Tappe inside. You danced around a little foul trouble with both of them. And Traore, he's a physical player on the other side for the Cougars.
Yeah, I thought Traore got us a little bit, especially in the first half on some putback dunks. And was a little more active around the rim defensively. Had 2 blocks, it shows. Thought it had a little more than that. And then Atiki came in, was pretty physical. I thought we did a good job on Loner until late. He hurt us late. And, I thought Yann was okay. Not his best game, but, we got to be able to win without him being an all-star. I thought Pat was pretty dang good. Start to finish 12-7. And, foul trouble was not great for him. And I thought he had some soft calls in the second half. And it just put us in a bind. Couldn't keep him on the floor.
What was the mood of the guys like? I know I'm talking to a lot of your players. They had kind of circled this game on the calendar. A lot of you guys were really looking forward to this contest here tonight.
Yeah, we expected to win the game. We were the better team and didn't get it done, though. So I think you can probably guess they're pretty disappointed and, feel a little dejected and feel like we let an opportunity slip by.
Now, I know you have some schedule changes coming up. So for the listeners driving home that were at this ball game, people that are interested in USF, tell us what's going to happen on Thursday.
So it looks like we'll be heading up to Spokane on Thursday to play Gonzaga as opposed to Portland. And we'll move that Portland game to a little later in the conference season. It was really challenging to find a time to make this game up because we didn't want that to be a third game in a 3-game week. Fortunately, Portland was willing to take the bye and move it around a little bit for us. And so we'll be going up to Spokane and playing them on Thursday before going down to Pepperdine on Saturday.
And that came to be because the Pacific Tigers are in a COVID pause. They were supposed to be playing Gonzaga. So things opened up for the Bulldogs. You get on the phone with Mark Few and suddenly you got a ball game up there against the number 2 team in the country. That's obviously going to be now a challenge as you go up there on Thursday. Tell us about taking on the Bulldogs.
Yeah, I haven't thought about it a whole lot, to be honest, Pat, dealing with this game here. So definitely a challenge and, another opportunity to see what we got. And they've been running through people lately, so we're going to have to really go up there and compete the right way and see if we can give them a good fight. But this one, I'm more, just having to get over this
still,
one. And see
still, if can, still stings a little bit there.
A lot of bit, And we'll be ready to go for Thursday.
Coach, appreciate the post-game visit.